every single one of you humans. This week's video is one that I've gotten a few requests for, and that is how to create this time freeze type parallax effect, specifically this one from this Andreas Hem video. Take a look at this clip. As you can see, when we move the camera, there's a foreground, which moves faster than the midground, which moves faster than the background. That's the effect that we're trying to replicate. And the way that we replicate that effect in a still image is by taking that still image and cutting apart the foreground, midground, background, however many layers you may have, and spacing them out to create the illusion of depth. Then, to complete the effect, we'll just fill in the missing pieces for each layer and add a virtual camera motion. When you're shooting, you want to make sure that you have a very defined and separated foreground, midground, background, and other layers of depth in your clip. What I mean by that is that this image will not work for the effect, as the midground, which is the ground, is attached to the foreground, which is the person in frame. So we don't have a specific spot where we can separate the foreground from the midground. If you look at the image and you can see the place where one layer attaches to another, that clip will not work. Now, if we were to move the camera angle up a little bit, then we would have this shot, which does work because we can't see the place where the person is attached to the ground. Also, while you're shooting, you want to shoot clean plates if possible. Now, the way you shoot a clean plate is by shooting your final clip where you have your foreground, midground, background, all of your layers, and then moving the foreground out of the way. Then you take that shot where you don't have the foreground in the frame. Then, if possible, move the next layer out of the way and just take a photo of what's behind that. Then keep doing that for as many layers as you can. As you'll see when we start editing this, having more clean plates can create a more convincing effect, as well as save you a lot of time. Now that you've done that, we finally get to move on to editing. Start out by making your image into a new composite shot and looking at it to determine how many layers you'll need to separate. Then duplicate your image to create one layer in your composite shot for each layer in your image. As you can see, the example clip that I'm using has three layers, a foreground, midground, and background, so I'm going to duplicate the image twice. We'll start out by separating the foreground from the midground. I'm going to do this by using a mask, just masking around the edge of that layer to cut it apart from the midground. After we've done that, we need to switch to the layer under the foreground and paint in what is behind the foreground layer. The basic process is to use something like the clone stamp tool to cover up the foreground layer. You can do this using Photoshop if you have dynamic link, or pre-composing the midground layer in your editor. Now, this is where your clean plates come in. If you shot a clean plate without your foreground layer, then you don't actually have to do this. You can just substitute that and the foreground is already gone. So essentially what you're doing by painting out that foreground layer is creating a fake clean plate that goes behind the foreground. Now, just repeat that process for all the other layers in your clip. Mask out what's shown in one layer to separate it from the shot, and then cover it up in the layer beneath that. Now we are almost done, and the final step is to add that fake camera motion. Convert all of your layers from 2D to 3D, and then add a camera to the composite shot. Now, space out all of those layers, pushing layers that are further away in the clip further from that virtual camera. So what you've done here is taken that space between the different layers in your location and mimicked that in your composite shot. Finally, let's create that fake camera motion. The easy way to do this is to keyframe the animation of the camera to move and then add a camera shake effect for a little bit more realism. But if you have some extra time on your hands and want a little bit more realism, you can actually take the camera motion from an actual clip and essentially map that onto your virtual shot. Start by getting a clip of you moving the camera in the way that you want it to move in the final shot. The way that I'll do this is by taking a piece of paper and drawing two points on it, then taping it to the wall and just doing that camera motion. Having the dots on the piece of paper in your shot gives you something to track in editing so that you can take that camera motion and add it to the camera in your scene. Take that clip, add it to your composite shot, and stabilize it using those two points. Now, if you parent your virtual camera layer to that clip, then you'll see that that virtual camera actually moves in the same way that your real camera did. Anyway, that is all for this week, and if you did enjoy this video, feel free to share support by leaving a like or even subscribing to my channel. I upload new filmmaking and video editing tutorials every single Saturday. Keep creating, and I will see you in the next one.